Welkom terug hier by die Groot Ontbyt, Groot FM 90.5, kanaal 144 op Kijknet. En ek het hier die mooie dames verruil, ek het gesê, en iemand sê, my man sê nie dankie, dat julle journaliste so mooi is, dis nou Marnay, wat prachtig is, maar nou sit ek met net ons al drie. I think we're beautiful people. Did you get what I say? I just said yes. I don't know how beautiful we are, with baller tones.
We're about fives.
Yeah, out of...
I'd say we're all fives.
Five out of four.
I'm a three. Do you like my shirt?
That's very interesting.
Yeah, it's because dragonflies.
I go find your nagelkokers.
Nagelkokers?
Yeah.
Nagelkokers.
Is it a nagel or nadel?
It's a naalde.
Naalde.
Naalde koker.
Yeah.
Like, what is naalde now?
Needles. Yeah.
Yeah, a needle cooker.
Needle cooker doesn't even make sense.
A needle cooker.
A dragonfly. I mean, the Afrikaans is descriptive like that.
Yeah. So for the mense wat nie weet nie, voor my sit Kaan, lead singer Politans. If you don't know that by now.
Hallo mense.
And then Paul, difficult surname Hodgson's.
Hodgson. Think about like a hot shin.
Okay, because Hodgson sounds like a disease.
Paul, that is the most complicated. When I love it when salespeople phone me like, "Hello, can I speak to Mr. Paul?"
Hodgson,
Mr. Paul. So we're going to talk just a bit of background, and then the new double album. But the first time, basically, I interviewed you, and I said it before. You were still working at the bank.
Yes.
It's a long time ago.
It was 19 years ago. Yeah.
You all had day jobs. You were a muser forever.
I was probably working with my dad doing computers still then. Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
If you look back now, let's start, Kaan. Are you still amazed?
Yes, on TV.
You're on TV. You're not behind the desk.
Yeah. I think, you know, often when you're on a journey like this, you forget to sometimes actually look back and appreciate what you've achieved and done and experienced. Because you're always kind of looking forward, you know, like what's the next thing? What's the next project? Where's the next tour? You know, where's the next country? So, you know, we've had a few moments of reflection. We wrote a book about 2 years ago. We called The Stories Behind the Songs. Paul's also... written a book that documents the journey. And when you're doing those kind of things, you kind of realize how many cool things you've done. And we're very, very grateful and very privileged to, you know, be one of those bands and, you know, collective musicians that have had a career.
Mm. And then I'm so happy you said Paul wrote a book, because like Glenn running Comrades and stuff like that, and Neil selling paintings worldwide. And I thought, what's Paul doing? It's just a muso. Luckily, you wrote the book.
He's working. Yeah, he's looking up.
I'm a house husband. I do dishes and
you do dishes.
Do drive to school.
And actually, my question, talking about that, is you know, the different stuff you guys did in 20 years, just evolving as humans, growing up. Something like Neil that all of a sudden, you know, paints and it's just amazing. Was that just a natural evolving?
When you said evolving as humans, I thought he was going to say he grew a third arm or something.
Yeah, but a drummer.
That's his painting arm.
Opened all three arms.
He's a little primitive, yeah.
Yeah. So was it surprising or was it very natural?
Mm. Also, you're kind of going from being very busy. Like our early days, we were like 5-6 days a week. And then you got time for nothing else.
Mm.
But as you sort of play less shows, but bigger shows, you get more, a little bit more free time to explore those things.
Then the whole solo career, combining it with the band, was that difficult? Or was it also just a natural process?
No, it was pretty natural. I mean, you know, my first love as a musician is writing songs.
Mm.
I always have a lot of songs in my little box of songs. So that was a natural progression, and I try to make it slightly different.
Mm.
It is more difficult because it is my voice. It's kind of on both projects. But, Politones is still my first love. That's just another, you know, it just so happens to be that music's my hobby.
Mm.
So when people say, what do you do in your spare time? Well, I write songs.
Keep going.
So where am I going to put them? I'm going to, you know, create other projects.
Mm. And then family time, you know, you've got kids and wives and fitting it all together?
Was singular.
Difficult. Lucky.
We have wife.
Yeah. We don't all share one wife.
Yeah. Oh, you don't share. I thought it's you're bohemian. But was it difficult in the beginning days, you know, like you said? I mean, now it's more, I mean, you more focused and you can choose more gigs than just taking everything and being on the road the whole time.
We still do long overseas tours. Yeah. I mean,
we're going to chat about overseas.
Like four weeks or 6 weeks, you know. Sometimes in America we used to do 8 weeks at a stretch. But I sometimes think it's a little bit better. Like you get that space, and then when you come home, you've missed everyone, and it is hard.
Mm.
But ultimately, it's been good for some of our relationships.
You know,
they like us more when we're gone.
Yeah,
well, it's easier to be away from your wife for a while than your kid. That was hard. My daughter was like 2 and 3 and small when we were touring. So we'd miss a lot of those.
Yes.
Turning points when they're small, you know, when they get older, like the change isn't that drastic, but those early years you miss some things, which was not easy, but I mean, it's, you know, we're fine.
It's life. So we're going to talk about the album, Bless You, a bit later, and then I'm going to explain to people why the Parlatones and Nina Simone is basically the same artist.
The huge amount of talent. Something happened.
Yeah. Oh, right. This is interesting.
Legendary.
Are you going to be curious?
Yeah, I'm very curious. Yeah.
Okay. Parlatones and Nina Simone, wat het hulle in gemeen? Baie dankie, Hendrie. As jy net ingeskakel het, ons selfs met the Parlatones in die ateljee, hulle gaan ook optree in ons parkeerarea. So as jy op pad werk toe is of gym toe is, los het vir vandag en kom check hulle uit. Dit gebeur so 'n bietjie later en jy kan ook op YouTube ons kanaal gaan kyk as jy dit gemis het die eerste deel.
As jy jou gym wil opgekry, moes maar net kom juggle saam met hulle.
Kom dans. So now, juggling. I said, Hendrie missed this.
famous for juggling. I want to see jugglers.
Hendrie missed it now because he wasn't here. So Hendrie, I said, the Parlatones and Nina Simone's got something in common. Do you guys know what it is? You've never covered.
She was fond of alcohol.
okay, then, a different question. Who wrote Hello, Hello? okay, so Nina Simone she disappeared with her music, and then her music was used for like years. It was nowhere. They used one of her songs in an ad, and it was "My Baby Just Cares for Me," and it just made her famous internationally. And that's what happened with you in Ireland. Your music was used in an ad.
That's right.
And it opened up international platform.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sure. It's almost like you did some research or something.
Yeah. Yeah.
You didn't
very
just
rare
open
for
Wikipedia.
A journalist to do some research.
Yeah. Parlatones. It's very, very rare.
Formed in 1998.
Yeah. 1998. Yeah. So overseas, difficult or the most fun country and most difficult one to kind of break into?
I think there's fun and difficult aspects in all of those in all the countries that we tour in. America's difficult because it's so vast, it's so big, you know, so you spend 10, 12 hours driving every day to get to the next sort of destination, and there's a lot of nothing in the middle. Mm. But it is fun and it is exciting. I don't know, Paul, do you want to... Japan was cool because it was a complete cultural, you know, shift.
Russia as well, like utterly foreign.
No.
Like if you're in Germany, you can kind of look at a sign or a menu
and have an idea of what's going on.
Yeah. Japan and Russia, it's just like.
And then, you know, because the Western world kind of is quite entrenched in Europe, you know, more like American culture.
Yeah.
There's a lot of familiarity, but in Japan and, you know, there's nothing's in English. You just pointed a picture and hope that you're not going to get rat.
We ended up playing darts with some dudes in a bar. None of us could speak a word to each other, but we were laughing, joking.
Yeah, we had a good time.
About that. I'm sure they were just teaching us swear words. It's basically the same
as an English band going to Hartenbosch over December. Total different culture. Menu. Okay, the new album, China. Double album, new stuff, old stuff. What did you do?
Well, it's all new stuff. We did re-record a new version of Lisa Cyclothede because it was never on an album. It was only
the video.
Music video,
On MK. It was on one random compilation album.
Yeah, there was
a newspaper or magazine. And if you didn't get that CD, you couldn't get it.
But I mean, people really spoke about that. you guys doing that version in the Afrikaans version. So yeah, did you change it a bit?
Yeah, I said I corrected my Afrikaans. Yeah, I said nah. But the original one, I said fur. I didn't know it was incorrect.
Yeah, but you also you learned those days phonetically. You didn't know what you were singing.
No, exactly.
You were like totally. Yeah. This is amazing, Mark. I had phonetics geleerd. It was a great cover.
Crazy.
Yeah. That but I now know what I'm saying.
And then, and then just quickly, Taste Like Music. There's a new event coming up. They're just changing the date. People can go to tastelikemusic.co.za. Nice concept. The music with the food.
Yeah, I think so. You know, it's and it's like a dinner type performance. Yeah, I think it's always. I don't know. I think it'll
just
be great.
Just go.
It's going to be a jewel.
A nice environment.
It's at Legends, which is a great destination. I've been there a few times. So,
great. Okay, and then a tour launching. What's happening 2019?
We are actually currently on tour, which kind of will end maybe June-ish. You know, we've been going around the country. August we'll go. There's a few festival dates that we got in Europe, and then in October, November we'll do a full tour of Europe. It'll be about 6-7 weeks, and then then we'll be back here for the summer. And in between all of that, we'll try to spend some time with our families.
Yeah, definitely. What are you going to perform for us this morning? In the
I think A Beautiful Life, area? Which is a song from the new album, and then Lisa.
Yeah. So, weer eens kom na ons parkeer area toe. Guys, thank you so much.
And bring your juggling equipment.
Ja, ons raad toch nog steeds kunstenaars op de sikkel om hier te krijg, so vroeg in de oogend. Hierdie ons het ingepoel voor 6 uur in die donker en kom opstel in ongelooflike koue in Pretoria. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
That's why you're legends.
Yeah. That's why. Yeah.
Great stuff. Awesome.
Apparently Nina Simone did the same.
Yeah, yeah precies.
Apparently we juggle, she used to drink out of a jug.
Ja, erg
gesien.
Maar sy moet net die vanoggend saam sing en dan haar klip ek. Ons hele gaan nou iewers moet oproep. So baie dankie.